Okay, good evening, everybody. Nice to see you all here in church. What a nice crowd tonight, and we're glad that you're with us. We'd also like to welcome those who are joining us by the internet. We're happy that you take the time to check us out on YouTube or Facebook. We hope that our videos will be a blessing to you and enriching of your life. So we want to thank you for being with us tonight here in the sanctuary, and for you who are joining us. Don't forget, if you're in the area, we'd love to welcome you to our church service Sunday evenings at 6 o'clock at 409 East Broadway here in Vancouver. You will receive a warm Renaissance welcome. And so thank you for joining us. God bless you, and we're going to continue on in our service now.
Today is World AIDS Day. Well, I'm just going to talk a little bit about that. Each year it coincides with the start of Advent. And this presents opportunities for thoughtful worship that draws together the themes of Advent with the many concerns surrounding HIV/AIDS. Medical science in developed countries may make us a bit complacent about a condition that came to our attention in the early 1980s. Yet more than 65,000 people are currently living with HIV in Canada. An estimated 89% are diagnosed, 85% of those diagnosed are on treatment, and 95% of those on treatment have achieved viral suppression. This is amazing for a disease that was considered a death sentence not so many years ago. Globally, however, the picture is not the same. An estimated 33.3 million people have HIV. And sadly, the vast majority of those do not have access to the treatments and the healthcare available in our country. In South Africa alone, it's a very, very serious issue. Throughout Africa, throughout the world, it's a serious issue. Dr. Nathan Ford, in the New England Journal of Medicine earlier this year, said, "The proportion of people with advanced HIV remains high. It is estimated that 4 million people have advanced HIV disease, and each year, more than 600,000 of them will die. Worldwide, more than 25 million people between 1981 and 2007, I didn't see a statistic for past that, but for in that period of time, 1981 to 2007, more than 25 million people died from this virus, making it one of the most destructive pandemics in history. I, and many of us, have probably lost friends to HIV and AIDS. I've lost close friends and colleagues from work to HIV and AIDS. And so tonight I remember them and I commemorate the loss of their friendship. I commemorate their lives. But we also remember those throughout the world who need our prayers. May God help them to receive the treatments and the love that they need to beat this terrible disease. May God open the doors to allow them to get the treatments they need as well. We tend to forget them, I think, sometimes because things are pretty good in Canada, but we do need to pray for them and remember them. So may God bless them and touch them. At this time, Mr. Blake is going to come and he's going to sing a song for us.
I'd just like to say, I don't know whether any of you remember Dr. Peter, and he was CBC shows, and he went blind, and he had his dog Harvey, and he used to come over to my house, and his mother just passed away a few months ago. Anyhow, I wrote this song, Our World, and it deals with I mean, with the red ribbons there, and also deals with a lot of other issues in the world, which seem to continue on every day.
Yeah.